little different. Okay.
All right, real life. I mean, ready? Let's go. Hey, Kiki.
Hello, Kiki.
Show the video. Thank you. Hello, Tamika. How are you? Please share the video as you guys are coming in.
Hey, Sherry.
Hello, Sherry. As you come in, please share the video. Hey, Delvin, how are you? I miss you so much, Delvin. I'm trying to get over there to see you.
Luke Johnson Baker.
Hey, Dwayne, Dewan, Cousin Dewan. Leo Aquilon from high school, how are you? Hello, Cousin Candace, how are you? Glad to see you guys coming on in. Hello, Mom Ruby, how are you? Hello, BFF Nina, how are you? You guys, as you're coming in, please share the video. Please share the video. You all get some hearts for Jesus. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. We are so excited to be here. So as you're coming in, share the video, share the video, share the video, share the video. We want to get as many viewers as we can. This is going to be a hot topic. And as you know, today, my sister Tradon is on the hot seat. Is the staple there?
Okay.
My sister Tradon is on the hot seat 2 weeks ago. I was on the hot seat, and our topic was single, saved, and celibate. So we have a different topic today, especially for the married. And I'm sure she's going to provide a little bit of encouragement to the singles as well. So as you're coming in, share the video, share the video, share the video, share the video, share the video.
Hey, Lauren.
My colleague Lauren, hello. Yes, he has already made a way.
Amen.
Hello, First Lady Clark. Thank you for tuning in. Share the video as you ladies are coming in. Thank you for coming in. As you're coming in, please share the video. Don't know how, but I'm grateful. Anybody grateful?
Yes.
Because you made a mountain mover.
Yes, he is.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hey. Hey, Mary. Deaconess Mary Thomas, how are you? Linda Tankson, thank you for tuning in. Linda Wilkins, thank you for tuning in. As you all are coming in, please share the video. Share, share, share.
You call the walls too far.
Hey, Sean Sanford, how are you? Hello, everybody. Hey,
hey
Sierra.
Everybody.
Hello,
hey,
hello
Sierra.
Everybody. As you're coming in,
please
share the video. This is the day that the Lord has made.
Praise
Let us
God.
Rejoice and be glad in it. We're so thankful and grateful just for everything that God is doing.
Thank
and we'd
you,
like
Lord.
To take this opportunity to welcome you to
Holiness Hills
and
Hankies.
I'm Damika, and this is
Tradonna.
And she's the married girl. I am the single girl. And we are just glad to uplift Jesus and encourage
Praise
you
God.
Where you are in your walk as a married woman, as a married man, as a single woman, and as a single individual,
Praise
as a single
God.
Man.
Hey, Paris.
Hey, Paris. We're excited, guys. As you're coming in, please share the video, share the video, share the video. And so this is our second video for the year of 2018. I'm so excited. Holiness Hills and Hankies. We started. Hey, Ronald. How
hey.
Are you? How are you, Ronald? Thank you for tuning in. We started this last April. So in a few months, guys, we will be celebrating 1 year.
Yay.
1 year. It's amazing. So God is opening some doors. Hey, Tammy, thank you for coming in. Please share the video. God is opening some doors, and Holiness Hills and Hankies has some great things
Amen.
On the horizon.
Amen.
We're excited about what God is doing as we are building our brand with the spirit of excellency, professionalism, and wisdom.
Amen.
And so we're glad about everything that God is doing. So look for us. My sister and I have discussed some things. We have some things on the table. We're going to be doing Holiness Hills and Hankies on location.
Amen.
So that means we're going to be on a plane, flying out as people request us to come encourage their married and their singles in ministry. So we're excited about everything that God is doing. It's been a great day, great Sunday,
yes.
a great time in the Lord this Sunday morning. So we hope that you enjoy Jesus on today, and we're coming to encourage you this morning. I'm back in church, right? Sound like I'm back in church. We come to encourage you this morning. We're coming to encourage you this evening with a topic that we feel that will be encouraging to you guys. Lord, if you make a way, I'll stay. Hashtag married. Lord,
Amen.
If you make a way, I'll stay. Hashtag married. And so, again, as you guys are coming in, welcome again to Holiness Hills and
welcome
Hankies.
So
Please
much.
Share
yes.
the video. My sister's going to share a passage of scripture with you guys, and then we're going to continue on.
Okay, so as I was preparing for this, I really was blessed today in service. And the scripture that I want to share with you all that encouraged me was from Isaiah 43 and the second verse, where it says, "When thou passest through the waters, I will be with thee, and through the rivers, thy shall not overflow thee. When thy walkest through the fire, thy shall not be burned, neither shall the flame kindle upon thee." And we were just reminded today that you will experience hardships, you will go through things, and we're talking about marriage today, but just that I want to encourage everyone that anything that you're in will experience, that God is always with you.
Amen.
So that was the blessing in knowing that. So we're going through these different things, and then eventually you shall come out of these things, and it shall be remarkable, is what Pastor Austin told us today, that it shall be remarkable. So we are really excited about that, and just to encourage you guys with that scripture, that you will, there are things that you're going to go through, there are experiences you're going to have, there are trials and tribulations, but remember that God does not leave you. He has not forsaken you. He has not forgotten about you. So
Amen.
Be encouraged in
Amen.
That, and knowing that your coming out will be remarkable.
Amen. That's what he was saying, that your coming out will be remarkable. And we believe and we know because of our own experience that God is faithful.
Amen.
He's a faithful promise keeper to the promise seeker. That's what I always say.
Amen.
God has a purpose. God has a plan. God has a promise. And so we stand upon those things regardless of where we are in our walk as
right.
a Christian married woman, as a single married woman. We know as a single woman, not single and married, but as a married woman and
hey
as a single, hey El, hey John, hey
Kamichis.
James, hey Evangelist Kamichis, thank you all for coming. And as you come in, please share the video, share, 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 share. But she was saying that Pastor Austin said that we're going to come out remarkable. So we believe God,
Amen.
That he's with us in whatever process, in the beginning, in the middle, and the end. He never leaves us, nor does he forsake us.
Amen.
So we serve an awesome God.
Amen.
Amen. So we're excited about today's topic. My sister is on a hot seat. A couple weeks ago, I was in the hot seat with single, saved, and celibate.
Amen.
Got a lot of inboxes, some that were kind of crazy. But we praise God for allowing us and giving us the strength, the wisdom, and
equipping us to walk in celibacy.
Right.
And it's not an easy journey. So I was glad that so many people were blessed by my transparency, because I told my sister that was the one thing I wanted to make sure that was communicated to our viewers, is that walking in celibacy is not easy because we all have desires. But today we're talking about walking in marriage. And so I know that the topic may have been misleading, so I'm going to ask my sister to talk about that. But before we talk about that, I want to talk about what social media has been sharing as it relates to Jay-Z and Beyonce. Has mm-hmm. everybody had a chance to see that video? Oh my God. I was so encouraged by Jay-Z.
It was the one where he's doing an interview
right.
in New York. I can't remember who's doing the interview. I would have gotten
the information. Yeah, I got the quote though.
Okay, good.
Okay, I got the quote. So the gentleman who was interviewing Jay-Z, he said, "What is about this marriage that you fight so hard to save it?" Jay-Z's response was, Why fight for your marriage? It's my soulmate, the person I love. You can be in love and love someone. And if you haven't experienced love, He said, you can be in love and love someone. And if you haven't experienced love and you don't understand it and you don't have the tools to move forward, then you're going to have complications, period. Mm-hmm. You can either address it or you can pretend until it blows up at some point. For us, we chose to fight for our love, our family, and to give our kids a different outcome, to break that cycle for Black men and women to see a different outcome. We chose to fight for our love.
Mm-hmm.
We were never a celebrity couple. We were a couple who just
Van
happened
Jones.
To be celebrities. I love that. He said, Van Jones, okay,
yes.
Thank you. And so he said, we were never a celebrity couple. We just were a couple who happened to be celebrities. And I thought about that. We were never, you know, because you can put so many different careers into that you can insert into that.
Right.
Because you may not be a celebrity. We were never celebrity preachers. We just happened to be, you know, if you switch that up.
A preacher couple. Just
right.
like a couple that... also our preachers
right.
or a couple that's this or a
right.
couple that's
right.
that. But
so,
they chose to fight. He said we chose to fight for our marriage. And that was from Jay-Z. And go ahead.
I wanted to get your take on that.
Mm-hmm.
Because I thought that was so interesting. My sister and I had a conversation about it. And I told her we were going to open up our show with that. But when I was telling her, I was telling her that I thought there was such a mature answer that Jay-Z gave, because we're living in a society where so many people are not fighting for their marriages. So many people are walking out for stupid stuff. They're
mm-hmm.
they're changing partners like they're changing jeans.
Right.
You know, and so what's your take on that? What do you think of Jay-Z's response?
I thought it was so profound. And, you know, I don't know his if he's saved or, you know, I'm not gonna, whatever it is, but just somebody, this billionaire rapper, is like, man, like, no, we made this decision. What I like, he said, it was a choice. You know, I think that's the biggest thing that stood out to me with that, is that it is a choice. It was his choice to stay married. With him and Beyonce, that was a choice, and that was you have to do that. Like, they decided, no, we want something different for our family. They stood for what they wanted to stand together, and they wanted something different, so they decided to stay married. So
yeah.
I thought that was awesome that he said,
yeah.
I'm making this, we made this choice,
yeah.
and we're going to stay together.
Yeah, and you can look at the level of maturity, the conversation, that
right.
his answer was a mature answer. He just looked like a man to me. He looked
mm-hmm.
like a man. The answer that he gave was the type of answer that a man who wants his wife,
right.
who wants his family, you stay and fight. We just don't give up on this. And I think that's what has happened so much,
right.
not only in the secular world, but in the church as well. So many people are giving up on their families. And Sean said, we give up way too quick. And that's
right.
been my experience. That's been when I talk to other people and I'm like, you can't work this out. There's nothing that you all can do. People are throwing in a towel over stupid stuff, you know? And it's unfortunate that, we don't fight for our marriages like we should. So, and I'm sure that my sister is in no way feeling like she's an expert, but when you have some experience in marriage, you can offer some advice. And so
yes.
that's what we want to do, as she encourage you all.
And just with that, so I do want to say definitely the any married women, please come in, share with us, talk with us too, because I'm definitely not an expert, but I can say that what I have experienced, I have learned so much, and I'm just excited to share those things with you. So I was hoping my mom, about have her on text, like, just in case I need something, because I will, like I say, that was like my first example of a wife, of how to be a wife. I watched my mother do. They've been married for, I believe, 47 years in
February
27th.
They
would have been married 47 years.
Mm-hmm.
So she was my first example to see how you did as a wife. Like, what are you supposed, the behaviors, those characteristics of a wife were definitely seen from my mother. So I hope she's has her phone out. So if I had to text her something, because that's my go-to person when I want to have a question about being married and staying married. So that's who I go to. So I'm by no far an expert, but I definitely wanted to share my testimony on marriage.
Hey, Jay, thank you for coming in. Please share. Damon, we see you. Please share. Tawana, share the video. So, okay, so we said again that our show theme is Lord, if you make a way, I'll stay married. I wanted to talk about that because after I had shared the flyer about 7-8 times, my sister said, you know, why did you call it Lord, if you make a way, I'll stay? She was like, he's already made a way. Yeah. I said, yes, he has. And so then I went on to say, but so many people that are struggling in their marriages, they feel like they feel like the Lord hasn't made a way. Talk about that, because that was your response. He was like, he's already made a way.
Right.
You know, so talk to people
about
that.
And so her explanation was definitely valid, because I too have felt that way too. Like forget it. Like there is no way. I don't see any coming back. I don't see any way that this is what God wants me to have. Or wants me to be in. So just to be open and honest, that I felt that way. So when she said that, I was like, yeah, you're right. That maybe is how people have felt. But my response to that is that God has made a way already. God doesn't leave you. God wants us to stay married. He wants us to be the example for him with marriage is that the husband should love his wife as Christ loves the church. So he wants an example out there. I know right now there's such an attack on marriages. I'm seeing it. I'm hearing it from so many people. So he doesn't want to.
Mama.
Hey, Maj, you just missed your shout out. but he does not want us to stay married. So there is such an attack on marriages. So, but I'm here just to tell you that God has made a way. Mm-hmm. So there's no out in marriage. There's no say, okay, it's over. That's not the way it was designed. So he has made a way. So you can stay. You can stay married.
Yeah, and there's so many blessings that are attached to marriage.
Amen.
Even without being repentant, you know, so there are so many. Just the Bible says, "A man to find the wife, find the good thing, obtain favor with the Lord." So even without being saved.
No, this is not a topic for just married couples only. So I don't want you to leave out.
No, don't leave. We're gonna talk, and I'm the single person too. Yeah. So we're going to be getting some wisdom from this as well, because right. There are some things that we can learn and we can take to that. Because we're praying that God sends us the man of God, right? And so we're going to be touching on some single stuff,
right,
too. So. Some questions that I have for her that will be a blessing to you. So please don't leave, Renee. Stay with us. And my mom is on here. And we did say that you've been married for 47 years. And so we plant ourselves with people. Don't you think that's a benefit?
Yes.
Who have are successfully working this marriage thing. And one thing that you mentioned that my best friend always talks about is you don't have an out. I think so many people think they have an out because, you know, because a situation can be tumultuous, mm-hmm. but they're so quick to throw in the towel.
Right.
You know, so some of the outs that we take are based on just, you know, because I don't like the person
right.
no more. You know,
right.
but that's you don't get an out. You don't have the option of you have the option, but you should not be getting divorced because you're tired of the person.
Right.
And I want to say as a single say this for Renee, as a single person who is divorced, I still believe in marriage. I still believe in the covenant of marriage. I believe that there are good men out there. I believe that there are good women out there. And marriage is a beautiful thing. So I encourage the people that are single on here, don't get discouraged because you have a girlfriend who's telling you, or you mm-hmm. have a guy friend who's telling you how tumultuous, how challenging it is. It is a workable institution when it's done effectively and it's done right.
Mm-hmm.
And as my sister said, God has given us, he's equipped people with the tools that you need to do it right. You know, so she can talk about that a little later, maybe some of the tools that her and Josh use. And she mentioned she was very transparent. She said sometimes she wants to throw in the towel.
Mm-hmm.
But we can't do that. God will strengthen you. Wouldn't you say that God has strengthened you to hang in?
I would definitely say that he has definitely strengthened me. And even with this, I can say being married has definitely given me the opportunity to grow a closer relationship to God. It has increased my prayer life. It has increased just my relationship with God. It has become like so tight and strong. And I know other married women could agree. Like,
mm-hmm.
but God and I are close, you know. So
so what you're saying that is what's benefited you and strengthened your marriage is you seeking God.
Exactly. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
So we've become so. So, I love God, you know, that's who I can depend on with anything, and just who I can, I can always go to and who listens, you know, I think that's been my greatest benefit is that my relationship with God has just been become so much stronger. So that's my greatest blessing.
Amen. And then even for singles, you know, because your relationship with God has to be strong with or without a spouse. Amen. So what it does in the midst of any type of challenge, it keeps you on your knees as a married wife,
right,
as a single woman. So to the married and to the singles, we should always be striving to develop and strengthen our relationship with the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. So one question that we got, we're going to give it our questions. And if you guys have some you got some comments or questions on here, I hope I'm not skipping anybody. Renee says, okay, cool. Thanks here, lady. Most people have been excluding us who have never been married. I still believe my time is coming. And Renee, we really don't want you to leave because I'm the single one. And so we provide a perspective for both. And even when I get married, holding these heels and hankies, we're still going to have somebody on here to address the needs of single individuals.
Right.
Singleness is a different ministry in itself, but I don't know if this is your first time on, but we always address from a married perspective and a single perspective.
Right. And, I would like to encourage you, too, that your time will come. If that's what you ask for from God. It will come.
Amen. Mm-hmm. And Nina says, pray continuously. Jesus is a lifestyle that blesses marriages to grow in love and faith. Yes.
Mm-hmm.
And Tawana is saying to you, Renee, your time is coming. So we touch and we agree. Because I want a man of God too. I'm not ashamed to say it but I want a man of God. So what does that require me to do? Walk like a woman of God. And let me repeat that scripture because I heard Pastor John Gray, I believe, said it. That scripture I said earlier, a man that find the wife, find the good thing, attain favor with the Lord. Your wife even before you get married. So you want to carry yourself like a wife. He's looking for a wife. You got to be a wife. I don't become a wife when he marries me. I'm already a
wife.
And
that was a big thing before we go on. Maybe we can talk about that later if anybody has questions on that. But with the John Gray, like carry yourself like a wife. And so that was
a good
thing.
Video. Did you see it?
I did see it, but some people were upset about it.
Really? Okay. So one question we had, what if your partner speaks a different love language from you? That was a question that someone asked, and I took the liberty to look up different love languages, the five love languages. It's from a book, and I did not. Yes, it is. This quote is to Dr. Chapman. I don't know if this is the author of the book, but the five love languages are words of affirmation. This language uses words to affirm other people. Quality time. This language is all about giving the other person your undivided attention, receiving gifts. We know what that is. Acts of service and physical touch. Mm-hmm. So, what if you are with a partner who speaks a different love language from what you do?
Okay,
how do you handle that?
With that, I would definitely say, that could happen. First of all, I want to address those feelings. Like for a woman, like you, if you like whatever it is, if you like the physical touch, if you like gifts, or guys too, whatever you like, I could see the frustration in that. Like you don't want your partner to do this and they don't. And I think sometimes even with after communicating with them, that you want that, then it may still not happen. So, something I know if something that I want, do unto others as you should have them do unto you. I think maybe you should do those things to them and let them see how it, how they enjoy it.
So what's your love language? Do you know?
I think mine is probably, acts of service. I think, cause I like things like, things I like, it may seem like small, like I don't like to go put gas in my car or, just little things like that. So just that I don't have to, and I think my husband's, a mix. He probably like words of affirmation and, probably physical touch. I also like gifts too, though. I think maybe so if that's something that you want that they're not doing, just, I know first communicate that to them, but also then, show them like what, that means. I have a story, that I was telling this one lady who, I don't know if you know.
The milk.
No, this was a story where this lady I was telling, wives, rub your husband's head, like that's like really get a lot. So like,
so that's tools for your toolbox, singles.
Yeah,
rub your husband's head.
Rub his head, if it's bald.
Yes, hair.
He has
no hair.
Yeah, rub his head. And I told her so I was rubbing it, doing like this, and we was like, no,
that's a pat.
That's a pat. She said he kept pushing her head off doing like this. I literally showed her, and she was like, "Ooh, I do like that." I was like rubbing through her hair. Like, see, she was like, "Ooh, I do like that." So when she went back home, and then she did it, so he was like, "Ooh, girl." So she was blessed and rubbing his head. So I think just to show what you really want is important. You know, you got to show like what you mean. So just go ahead and
put that one in my pocket. Yeah, rub the man of God's head.
That's all you married women. Just rub his head. I mean, like caress it. So maybe we said rub. Maybe she thought like a dog, but caress his head.
She was just patting his head.
Yeah, she was patting his head. It may have been a language barrier, but I don't know. But she was She was patting his head. So show them. But if you have a different love language, do it. If you want foot rubs, or if you want whatever it is, then do that for them. And then like, then you just tell them, I like this too. I think you got to be open and honest. Say, yeah, I like this.
Because you got to know your partner's love language. Right. We can't, because language is a way to communicate.
Right.
So I can't communicate with you if I don't know what language you're speaking. If you're speaking Spanish and I'm speaking Turkish, we're never going to understand each other. So I think it's important. And I think they have like a little test that goes along with that too. You know, for some, it may be harder to decipher what their love language is. I think I'm a bit of both of them. I love physical touch. So can I talk about myself too?
Go ahead. Sure.
I'm just saying. You know, I'm saying singles got some stuff they like too. You know, so it's good to know your own love language.
Right, right.
And then in dating, learning that. You have to have a conversation when you're dating. You know, a lot of this stuff that married people struggle with, and I'm saying from a person who's been married before, had I had some conversations, I may not have even married that person. You know what I'm saying? I had some certain conversations that would have come up during the dating process. You know, because you just get that big old love bite, and you know, some certain conversations just go out the window, and you just all, you know, everything becomes so murky, you know, that you can't see the forest for the trees. You know, my mother always says, love is blind, but marriage is an eye opener, you know, because you start seeing some stuff that you may not have, that you would have, you know, had you not been so love stricken, you would have looked at differently. I want to read Mama's comment. She said, it's amazing. Your ministry says it all in marriage, holiness, heals, and hankies. Wholeness being saved is keeping power, heals, sexy, hanky, needed every now and then to wipe a tear.
Yeah,
that's good.
That
to
is
God
good.
Be the glory. My husband and I have total different love
languages. Yeah, so I think a lot of couples do. And I think that's okay if your love language is different.
I like what she said about wiping a tear sometimes.
Yeah, so you will have to wipe some tears. I don't know if I've said this earlier, but I will say this has not been easy. I will say like marriage is not easy, as it really isn't. But I will say it's still a blessing. So it's work. It's something that I have had to work at. I'm not always been like just so, oh, okay, honey, I'm not always like that still. I was that wife, didn't like something, I'm going in, you know, but you can't be that way. You know what I'm saying? I've learned that. You
God
can't be that way.
That
has definitely come from, I'm telling you, my relationship with God is so tight. It's so strong because of just trying to, you know, keep me here, keep me in a marriage. So I will definitely say that was our things that come from God, because I have, he has changed me. He has definitely changed me.
Hey, man, that's good. What advice would you give to engaged and soon to be married couples?
Oh, my best advice. Okay, definitely. So people that maybe engaged or soon to be married, I know the big thing is the wedding, right? So I would definitely say don't focus too much on that one day, because it's a lifetime afterwards. I say if you want to spend money on anything like with that, if you're getting married, I would definitely spend money on my honeymoon and like going somewhere with my spouse. I think that was like those trips and vacations, even if it's just somewhere with you two, go somewhere. And I've said this before, do something new, do something that you haven't done before. Together, because I think like these things build like good foundations. So don't spend too much money on like the wedding and the reception. You know, those things get to be very expensive. But build for your future, and I think part of that is building that foundation, definitely with new experiences. So with something exciting like an excursion. I remember I'm not a water person. So for me, we went to Jamaica. So and then we were swimming with the horses. So
like in the ocean.
So like you go in with the horses, and then the horses like you ride with them. It's so much fun. Then you get on. Then they take off the saddle, everything. You ride the horses bareback into the ocean. The ocean, not a lake, not a river, the ocean. Not, you don't see anything with water. And I'm not a swimmer, so I'm telling the guy, like, hold on to me. Josh was a little scared too. But the horses go berserk in the water. But this is a memory I will forever have, that I was there with my husband and did this. I will never forget that. So that's why I encourage. So with those people that are newly engaged, getting married soon, don't focus on that wedding is one day. Yeah. I think you get some beautiful pictures, but try to, you know, make sure you have still have a nest egg for like your home, and then go on a nice vacation. I think that's really important, because those things build memories. So with the single women, I think, you know, still, you know, make sure you have your passport, make sure you have all your stuff set to go, so you can take those trips with your husband.
Amen.
So, yeah.
Amen. And I think what I learned, if I could just interject, that's so true what you said. Because as a person who's been married before, you just learn that the priority is not the wedding. Mm-hmm. It's not the ring. I would love nice photographs. I would want to be, I tell my sister, just surprise me. Tell them, just, I don't even want to know about, I just want to know that we getting married in the same day. Only because there's so much to do, and you want to live after all of that is over, you know. So everything you said is correct. Mm-hmm. But for a first time bride, it's a little bit different. But the priorities have to shift. You didn't mention counseling. What do you think?
Oh yeah, definitely. That? Yeah. So I definitely have counseling. Well, we had some. I think even more been better. But definitely have counseling, or some definitely tools I learned in there, because I had a son already. Our blending families, which a lot of people may have to be blending families together. There's definitely some things that are going to have to take place. I could tell, like, I'm a reading teacher, so I always got stories, right? So one story I have, I'll never forget this, that was the greatest lesson I learned, was when we were counseling. Pastor said, let Caleb ask, now that, you know, Josh will be the head of the household, all these things, let Caleb ask. Next time he asked you, can I go somewhere or do something? He said, tell Caleb, oh, well, go see if Josh is okay with that. Mm-hmm. And I remember Caleb looked at me like, huh? But it was really like a turning point in our relationship, so that you could see, okay, this person that will also be included on those decision making mm-hmm. and things like that. So that was just one of the key things I learned from counseling. Many, many more, but definitely counseling. Please do that. Yes.
Amen. And Elle said, go on vacations. Hey, Willie. Yes. Hey, Michelle Macklin. Thank you all for coming in. Please share the video. Another question that we got. Do you feel that there is anything that a married couple cannot conquer?
No. We're conquerors, right? Amen. We could conquer anything. I guess if you're like in something that's abusive, or, you know, something like that, your safety. Mm-hmm. But I can still say, just from talking to so many married people that have been going through different situations, they still have seen couples overcome, you know, that as well. So I won't say that you can't even with that. Yeah. So, but you know, you want to make sure that you're safe. Yeah. But I believe that we are conquerors. God, I do believe God wants us to stay married. I don't believe He wants marriages to end. I don't believe that. So I do believe there's anything going on in your marriage that you can conquer. That I've heard the testimony of people coming back from so many different things.
Babies outside of their marriage.
Yeah, and they still are together, and they, you know, happy that, you know, they're both professing their happiness, their love, and that they forgave. So I do believe that you can conquer things.
Amen. Okay, so now the questions get a little bit hot, and we're going to ask you guys, if you have any questions, please type them in. I'm trying to make sure that I'm reading comments and answering questions. We do have some more questions that came in via inbox, and I tried to frame them in a way where we wouldn't be too graphic. Okay? here we go. How should I handle my husband having a different sexual appetite?
Okay. I don't know if it's more or less. I think whichever partner it is, I think that my mother always tell me, like, you want to deny your spouse. I was having a conversation with someone who she was about to get married, and I was telling her, you know, like, so sometimes maybe, you know, you just may be kind of tired, or whoever it is, somebody's a little tired, or, you know, like, life gets in the way. So I think, like, if you did say, oh, I'm sleepy one day, next day you need to make it up, you know. So next day you got to come real strong, you know, without getting like too. So I mean, you gotta come. Maybe you're gonna do some things that, you know what your spouse likes. You're going to do some things that your spouse likes. So if the day before that you were tired or something. So I think that, but I would just encourage you the next day to make it up, you know, and just blow their mind. You know what your spouse likes. So bring out some of the, some more tricks and fun stuff. Get the blue can of whipped cream, you know. So that's what I would say. So I think just balance it out. I don't think you should deny that person, your spouse at all. Again, I know things happen that sometimes be creative, being intimate. That's key. So
that's good.
So thank you so much. So if you were, the next morning. You don't want to wait too long too. So that's why I said that within the next 24 hours, you need to be, come on and go back and get them, you know, make that up to them. And you know what your spouse likes. So make sure that you do that. Make it up to them. Because they, need that. Mm-hmm. Okay.
I see you, before we go on to the next question. Someone wants to ask, how long have you been married? I meant to ask at the beginning.
No, he was. Okay, and how did I know he's my husband? Okay, good. So I've, this year I'll be married 6 years. I did not say anything. So I've been married 6 years. My husband's name is Joshua McAllister. How do I know? So I love our, so our first date was,
this is cute too.
Was, just awesome. He had called me for for about a month, I think it was, like 3 or 4 weeks. And I was just like, kind of playing to the left or whatever. But he was persistent, not bugging, but just really persistent. So he, I met him at the place, and then we got there, he said, what kind of car did you drive? I said, oh, I drove a Saturn. So he asked me to come out. He's like, oh my God, your car has a flat tire. And I was thinking in my head, like, oh my God, I hope he could change the tire. You know, I was kind of like, I hadn't felt like going out. But when when I came outside, so he had like a dozen roses in his hand, and he picked me up. And he's, I always say, he's been picking me up ever since. So,
I've been praying that God send me a man to pick me up. Send me a man to pick me up too.
So from the that was our first day. Then we were really like inseparable since then. I think by like our third or fourth day, I was kind of like, okay, God. And my husband did tell me, like, on our second or third day, he said, I'm looking for a wife. So he said those things too. Not said that saying he that I was his wife, but he definitely said I want to get married. You know, just saying the same things that I wanted as well too. So. We just kind of knew. A few months before we were having a wedding, we actually got married in June, a couple months before. So we had just went with the pastor, and we got married too.
And why'd you do that?
Just to make sure stay saved and be doing things the right way. Mm-hmm. Not because I was telling him I got a son here. You know, you about to get married. Things getting hot and heavy. So
you want to spend the night and stuff, right?
And not be married and then wake up my son, see him, you know, coming out the bedroom. So, we said, let's go ahead and get married. And we did. So.
Amen. Mm-hmm. Amen.
Sorry, we should have said that in the beginning.
Yeah. Sorry about that. All right. Mama said, Mama put down here, if they're a morning person, you're a night person. What do you do about that?
Yeah, so right now, our husbands, we work on different schedules sometimes. So, like, the times when he is off, I try to, make sure that we spend, you know, time together when he is, those off days. You know, you're not working 7 days a week, you know, you still have to make sure that you get it in. I heard one lady say, and if this works for you, she was a married lady, schedule sex. So, you know what I'm saying? So maybe you put it on a schedule, whatever you have to do to, make sure that's a part of marriage, you know, make sure that you get that in. So you want to, even if you need to schedule it. So if it's a morning person, night person, you know, then you just gotta make sure you get that time in.
I like what Annette said. He knew what he wanted and he stated his purpose.
Yep.
And she got intentional dating.
Right.
There's nothing more discouraging to me when I'm just kind of trying to figure out what a man wants.
Yeah.
Men that want you, they come get you. Don't you? Don't you think so?
Yeah.
I think that's a no for the singles. When a guy's interested, he is going to come get you. He no, hands down, you ain't got to be wondering, does he like me? Does he have a crush on me? You're going to know because he's going to actively pursue you.
Yeah, and, and that's what they say. Yes, he knew what he wanted. Yeah, he was there. Like, he was there all the time. He was there. Like, he was there. He started coming to my son's games, you know, building a relationship with my son, relationship with myself. You know, it was just, and it was really natural. I can't say it was anything that was just, you know, crazy or anything like that. But he knew what he wanted, and he showed up. He did. He showed up.
Yeah, he showed up and he showed
he
out.
Showed, he did. You know, he was there. You know, like, doing some, you know, start doing some man stuff, you know, it was, you know,
around the house,
you know, just, or make sure, but just
soon, make sure
my car was washed and all those things like that. You know what I'm saying? So I just.
And, Mama just texted me. She said the morning thing, the night thing, she wanted to specifically say that Donna was not, a morning person. Yeah. She's still not a morning person.
Yeah.
Mama said she changed. Not really.
Yeah. So I'm not a big morning, but my husband isn't either. So we don't mind sleeping in.
That's good, because I'm a morning person. I'm not a night person. Lauren says absolutely no guessing when a man finds his wife. That's right. You know, and it's for the singles that are like me, just kind of looking around like, you know, hello, hello. You know, I just believe that when a man wants you, he actively pursues you.
So want to say she's still missing.
No, she's not.
No,
she's not. She's not a morning person. Sometimes I call her and it's like, why did I do that? Sometimes early in the morning.
Do I consult my husband when I make a purchase of $250 or more? We talk about money all the time. So I don't know if anybody asked that, but I think one thing has helped me. I haven't been married long, but I think just being open and honest with money has been very helpful in our marriage. Like, you know, some people, like, they get a check or something, they may hide it, or that for me, we're excited, you know, with some money coming into the house. So we consult pretty much about everything about money. So I think it's nice, you know, have like your own little you know, if you got the savings that you want to save up for something. But you guys, like, now for something, we know we saving up for it together. I knew my husband wanted a motorcycle. He wanted a Spider, so, you know, he was saving up for that. So I think, we just have these conversations. I think just being open with money and have those discussions about different things you want to do, I think kind of alleviates some problems it can. So any other married women can chime in on that. But yes, we have discussions, open discussions about our finances.
Amen. That's good. And Annette said he wanted you and your son over, which is winning.
Yeah.
Because your package deal.
Yep.
Your package deal.
Yep.
All right. This is like the last question.
Okay.
Hey, Terry. It says, what if he or she is interested in being, and I framed this in a different way because this is not the way it came to my inbox.
Okay.
But I framed this in a way to make it more appropriate. What if he or she is interested in being a bit more adventurous, and this is sexually, than what you like? What if your spouse is interested in being a bit more adventurous than what you like?
I would definitely say with that, so we know in the marriage bed, I think people use it all the time, the marriage bed is undefiled. But if it's something that, you know, like some stuff that, like, you just don't want to do, I think they should be understanding, you know, if it's something that is just, you know, too freaky. That's all I'm saying. Like, if it's something that's just, like, too much, you know what I'm saying? Like, I think they should be understanding that if you don't want to, want to do that, you know what I'm saying? It's just like that's you know, too much for it, and too much for you to handle. I would just, those are where those conversations come. You know,
somebody wants to be in the video, Renee, somebody, we'll try to bring you in.
I would definitely say, if it, you know, I think it's, those are where those conversations come in.
You know Renee Loomis?
I don't know who that is. So I definitely, I don't know if they, I don't know, I guess they can still see me. But definitely, if it's something, you know, I can't see if it's, I don't know what, cause some people like pain or whatever it is, but I think if it's something, you know, that you could try, you know, then go ahead and, try it out. You know, I think you have to keep things
spicy.
Definitely. You want to, try some different things, do some things.
Nina said, be adventurous, stay open.
Yeah, so I would say stay open, but just be honest and open. And I think this goes back to, again, that communication. You want to just make sure that you, if it's something like that, then you want to take your time with some things like that. You know, do things slowly is what I would say. Like ease into some things. Yeah.
Don't you think that it
helps? What's too freaky? I guess if it's, you know, just depending on like your personal preference, you know, it may just be too much for you. Then you need to have that conversation. And then I think, like I said, I would still say is if it's something that you could try, then maybe, okay, you know, I think that would compromise it where I could do this, but maybe not all of that.
Too freaky would be like, can we bring a donkey in the bedroom?
Yeah,
I think, you know, that's just crazy, me, stuff, yeah, that like some people are doing.
Yeah.
You know, I think she wants an answer.
Okay,
so,
yeah.
To me, BC, that's definitely,
you know what I'm saying, that would be, yeah, like going like too, yeah, that's too freaky. Yeah, right. That's what I mean by that.
I think as a single, some conversations, once a relationship progresses to a certain point,
mm-hmm.
there's some stuff that we got to talk about,
right?
Because we kind of need to know. You don't want to get on this side of the marriage. Y'all changed my name and I married you. And
so, then yeah, I just want to say other people. You know, yeah, yeah. Like a threesome in the marriage. Yeah, so yeah, you want to communicate those things even in your singleness.
Yeah.
So especially just getting there. First, you know, how did you handle your first argument? How do I handle all arguments? I think I will go back to that. I have grown. So I like before, like I'm telling you, I would go in. It'll be a big fight. Somebody said donkey's abomination. Yes, it is. not letting things go. Just holding on to stuff, still like, you know, bringing it up like for days and days and days. So I think mm-hmm. it's still going with just, growth. So the first argument I would say was not as handled as, the best, but I think I know I have grown from that. So that's why I'm trying to encourage people now that are just getting married. And then I still also had, somebody to go to and talk to. So I think like even if as you get married, like have somebody don't want to tell all your business to, but just where you can talk to and just say, well, like you just asked, well, how do you handle an argument? Then just say something that can give you that advice, you know, like to just say something. You don't have to tell them the whole argument, but what should I do about this argument you want to handle that argument. So I'm sorry, my mother is.
She's really like sending us like pictures.
I don't know if you all can see this.
Beat it, bozo, and I'm flexible.
As she said, I'm flexible.
I don't want to hear nothing about being flexible.
My mom, that's what I'm saying. She keeps it real. With us, like letting us know, like what to do. So even with telling her, like you know, something could happen, like oh well, how should I handle like an argument? So definitely have those people that you can talk to with things. Then you can make up too. I think like especially when you first get married, it's a lot more making up love. So you want to make up sex, yeah. You know, you get, so it's okay to, you get, you have argument, just have, makeup sex afterwards. And, especially in the beginning. Yeah.
Okay. So did you guys have any more questions that you wanted to, share or ask for, my sister? Any more questions? Your mom is on point.
Yeah,
yes,
so that's, and that's be flexible.
47 years of marriage, and yes. I think when you say one quote that I use for a lot of stuff, if you don't want to be knocked off your square, watch who you keep in your circle.
Mm-hmm.
So you have yourself a circle of married, strong, yes, married people, yes, that you could always talk
definitely.
To.
Definitely. So I would definitely
and
encourage.
And hold you accountable.
Yep. Encourage married women to do that. Have some married women, married guys to have people around you that like love marriage and encourage, mm-hmm, marriage. Mm-hmm. You want to have somebody that you could talk to, you know, about things. And sometimes you'll be thinking about something or thinking some type of way, but they'll give you some, you know, some insight to how they got through, especially with 47 years. So she does have some insight. And even though, you know, that's my mom. So, you know, some things you can't say everything like I'm saying. But if you definitely gonna say, well, we had an argument, how should I go about, you know, doing it without, you know, going into all the details. She doesn't even ask all the details, you know, but she'll just, you know, tell me, you know, how to do things as a wife. You know, she'll tell me how I should handle certain things.
She's Tawana said, Donna, who plans the best dates and what was one of the best dates that you all had?
So, my husband, so I think, and that now that changes, so that's what I've noticed too now. So I think like as marriages, are shift. So, I was thinking about this. I was like, I know this wasn't one of the questions, but just to, you know, encourage women that sometimes, you know, man, like, oh, they were doing this or this, or like a man may say, oh, they were doing this and this. And I think as you are married, like sometimes things shift. So, the last year my husband was in the academy. He was, you know, like studying a whole lot. So like the planning of dates, it kind of like fell on me. So I was still trying to, plan, certain things, and he plans like phenomenal dates. I would say I'm trying to think, cause the first one that we were had, he's like, well, this is while we were still dating. He was like, we're going to Whoopi at the Ritz. And I was like, Whoopi at the, we had, you know, just hadn't been dating really that long. I was like, what? Like, no, we're not about to go, you know, do it at the Ritz. but what it was you went to the Ritz Carlton and we made Whoopi pies. And it was so much fun. They had like all the, they had these, you know, the Whoopi pies made, like we put toppings and all those things. And then we got the tour, the kitchen, we had a chef back there helping us. So that, I think that was fun. I'd say the most fun that we've had, on our, one of the dates. Well, and like, so he, or just even the things at home when you come home and you're surprised. So like he may, has just like put like a pallet on the floor, like with, rose petals and, something like that. And just we, dance. Now we out here just sitting out with the fire pit, lit, those things have been like really great, date nights. So I always try to, top him, but he does plan like really, the best, date nights. He does. He plans really nice things.
Okay. We're going to be closing out soon, but Nina said, what makes you stay when things become too much to handle? And she said, day nights are great nights.
Yes. So what makes you stay when things become too much to handle? So things have become too much to handle. Where so I don't want to like just ignore anyone. It's been like, man, it's like this is too much to handle.
Your purity in your marriage.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah, it will become times where you just like, man, like this is just too, it's too much. What has made me stay? I know God has been like there with me, but just the feeling of like, I want to be right. I want to be what God wants me to be. I want to be the example that he wants me to be. I want to do what he would have me to do. And just realizing the blessing in marriage and just doing what God wants you to do. I have been blessed abundantly. Things I can't even imagine. And with the biggest blessing being just my close relationship with God. So things just do get difficult. Things do become overwhelming, because from a woman's point of view, like the husband's, maybe, you know what I'm saying? It's hard. You know, some of the stuff you've been looking like, what? But I will say that the blessing in being a wife has been just really has blessed me. So that's really what made me want to stay and stick it out. And I know that God has some things that he wants me to do, and to also the opportunity to encourage other married ladies or people that are getting married. I get a whole lot of questions from that. That, you know, and just to encourage other women. So it's been a blessing in that.
Amen. And then said Christ the Savior makes you stay.
Yep, he does.
You learn the benefits of marriage.
Amen.
Amen. We're so thankful, guys. We pray that you were encouraged by the wisdom that my sister was able to offer. We pray that the married women were encouraged, the married men that are on here were encouraged. We pray that the singles were encouraged to know that marriage is a workable institution. It's ordained by God. There are mm-hmm. blessings that are attached to marriage. Get married. Get married.
Yeah. I do. I
when,
encourage
when the Lord
you that,
sends well, you the man, when God sends you the woman of God, get married. Don't be afraid of marriage. Right. Even after a bad experience, after heartbreak, heartache, hurt and pain, heartache, hurt and pain, I still believe in the sanctity of marriage. I believe in a good black man. I believe in a good leader. I believe in being a good wife. And I know that God has a special man for me.
Amen.
And
too,
for you.
The singles,
so don't give
there.
Up on that. Carry yourself like a wife. Carry yourself like the woman that God has called you to be. to be found.
Right.
So look like a wife, act like a wife.
Right. And so, and then she's saying that some of people were saying like, what do you mean? Like act like a wife, or, you know, it was like a big thing. Like some people were saying like, is a wife
that's
better?
That's a good thing. How do you act like a wife?
Like a wife. And I, what I would say is that you act like a wife by, doing, you know, I was busy. I was, doing things, and I'm not saying, cause some people saying like, oh, do wives think they're better? Cause like we, like you, mm-hmm. but not at all. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? I was just doing things that God wants you to do. And that's why I think it is like you, as you, even as you're single, do things that God wants you to do. And stay with God. That was my focus then. My, like, building myself, with God and that relationship with Him. And then I was found. That's why I could say I was found. That's what I was trying to do.
And don't get weary in well doing, being that type of woman.
Right.
I don't know if it was John Gray again. He said so many things about mm-hmm. relationships. But somebody else said, prepare your house. And busy to hear him, or someone else said, prepare your house for your spouse. I know my best friend is on here, and she's a prophet. She's like, D'Amica, clean out clutter. God, mm-hmm. the man of God is coming. And I said, she's right. I got all this extra stuff. You know, and even if we don't stay in my house, but you have to prepare your house, your body, mind, your mind, right. Cook, clean. Mm-hmm. So you do what a wife would do.
Right.
You know, a man, well, some men may not mind a woman that can't cook or that never cooks. They may not, if they're going to go out all the time, but there's a part of you that should be presented like a wife.
Right.
Where you're accustomed to doing wifely things. Am I right? Before the man of God
right.
comes.
Right. And then make sure you say those things for marriage too. You know what I'm saying? Like, don't, if you single, don't do all the things, you know what I'm saying, that you're supposed to do as a wife.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Don't do it. You know,
wait for him.
Yeah, for that man. Yeah. Make sure that you put an expectation on that. Like, so my husband came and was telling me that I want to get married. I want mm-hmm. this. And I was saying the same. That's what I'm dating for. Yeah. I don't mm-hmm. want to just be out here. Mm-hmm. I don't want to be your girlfriend forever. Yeah. So you got to make sure that you put those expectations. Let people know, like, tell them right up front. And
thank
then,
you for the hearts.
Thank
guys.
You guys.
Thank
you. And let them know that this is what you expect.
Amen.
You know, your expectations. If they're not the man, if they're not the one God has mm-hmm. for you, then they'll leave.
That's
you know,
right.
So I think
that's right.
It's not too that's early right. to, you know, it's not too, let me not say this too early. No, let mm-hmm. them know early on that that's what you want. And if they want the same thing, and if that's who God has for you, you'll get married. I promise you, it will be a blessing to your lives. There is not, so God makes a way for you to stay. That's how I want to end it. So I know we had to, if you make a way, I'll stay, because that's the way you may feel in marriage sometimes, mm-hmm. but know that God makes a way. God makes a way for you to stay.
Amen.
The song we, started out with, You Made a Way.
Amen. He made a way. Amen.
He made a way.
Amen.
God made a way. He made a way in my marriage. God made a way.
Amen.
And I encourage you. God will make a way for you too. I encourage you.
Amen.
Be prayerful, wives. Be encouraged. Read the scriptures. I promise you, I read scriptures. I put my husband's name in those scriptures. And you can see God has the king's hand. God has the heart of the king.
So God has the heart
of your king in his hand.
Amen.
And he will change hearts. He will do things. So be encouraged in your marriage. Be encouraged. Do not be discouraged when you're doing well, when you're doing what you're supposed to do. Do not be discouraged. God can change. He can change things around. I've seen it done. I have seen it done. And I was talking about for in my marriage, I've seen it done where God changes things.
Amen. Amen. So we're so grateful and thankful. You're okay. Mm-hmm. We're so grateful and thankful that God can change and rearrange marriages. He can change hearts and minds. And the scripture that you made reference to, the heart of the king,
mm-hmm.
the heart of the king is in the Lord's mm-hmm. hands.
Yes.
And so we bless God because God is able mm-hmm. to do anything.
Amen.
And that's why we cannot give up on God in
Amen.
Any situation, any circumstance. We
yep.
pray that you all have been blessed. We pray that you all have been encouraged. To the single woman, hang in there. Know that the man of God is looking for you. To the married woman, continue to be the married woman that God has called you to be.
Amen.
It's a great thing. Marriage is a great thing. Wherever God has you at in your life, we just want to walk the way that God has called us to walk.
Amen.
We want to do the things that God has called us to do, the way that He has called us to do it.
Amen.
God bless you guys.
Thanks,
we look forward
guys.
To seeing you in 2 more weeks. You guys, it's been a pleasure.
See
I love
you guys.
I thank my sister for being in the hot seat, for being so transparent about marriage. It's worth it all in the end.
Yes, it is.
It's worth it.
He'll make a way.
He'll make a way, and He's already made a way.
Amen.
Amen. Bye-bye. See you guys later. Love you so much.